These level one learners are studying for a qualification in plumbing. They are developing their skills and confidence in using maths to help them progress further through the course.
At level one, they require to be 3 grade E's. At level two, it's grade C's. And that's a big jump in a year. They do get a little bit confused. They get concerned about the numbers and how important it is. I try and impress upon them all that they must overcome the fear of failure, to challenge themselves, to have an open debate, to check each other and to know that they can work as a group, because in construction they are going to be working across different construction areas. And really, at the end, to know that they're not going to make fools of themselves.
The session is an opportunity for learners to explore and think about the maths that they will encounter as professional plumbers.
Essentially, the session today is the importance of understanding measurements with water, encompass VAT to set up an invoice, how much water physically costs, but most importantly, how much water weighs, because they tend to forget about that 1 litre of water will weigh 1 kilo. And if we've got a tank in the loft that's 1,000 litres, that's 1,000 kilos, half a car sitting in the loft. And they don't always see that, and it's important for them to see where they should place these tanks. So they do get stretched and challenged.
In this activity, the learners first have to calculate the volume of a water tank. They then have to source an equivalent tank using catalogues and online sites to determine the price and think about how VAT is calculated.
Try it out, see what happens. If you divide that up, so you've got calculators, let's try and see what it works out.
Divide by 1,000.
Divide it by 1,000.
Yeah.
Okay.
43233.
Right now we've got a big figure now. Yeah?
Yeah.
Is that going to hold 43,233 litres?
No.
I often see with students, like, we've got this particular tank here that I know is only going to hold circa 25 litres of water. They'll tap figures into a calculator and trust that the answer is correct. And they visibly see 450,000 litres and go, done it, that's it, that's the answer. For me, being in my old age and trying to get my old head on their young shoulders, is to estimate. It's a fundamental rule. They must be able to think, you know, slightly over is a lot better than a lot over, because they're just going to end up getting the wrong sizes.
43.
Now would you begin to see how many litres this could hold?
Yeah.
So that's the point I was trying to get to. You must be thinking, yeah, writing numbers on a calculator, it must be right. I've got all those figures correct, but does it hold 43,000 litres of water? So you've got 43.4, right?
Yeah.
So how did you get that figure into litres? What did you do?
Times by 100.
All right, so you convert at the beginning. That's the different way that these guys were doing it. Okay.
To source an equivalent tank, the learners are having to convert from litres to gallons.
So if we... I think 9.6. So then there's... It's 9.6 gallons.
10 gallon tank.
10 gallon tank.
Yeah.
So 1 gallon is 4.5.
Yeah.
Okay. I just worked out it's 9 gallons.
It's 9 gallons.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I've got one for depends what size.
So well, 9 gallon tank.
You got 9 gallons.
What's the closest to 9 gallons?
Who's not heard of VAT? Anybody not know what it means? A good percentage of the room never knew what the words VAT stood for. So again, it's drawing out, you know, these are voting age students. They have to understand that value added tax is a part of everyday life, and then understanding the actual amount of tax that is paid on the items that they're dealing with. So your figure was including VAT, which was how much?
£30.
Right.
Including VAT, yeah.
So you took off how much back then?
20%.
Right, so that's what I'm not, so, and you got a figure of how much?
£23.99.
Is that right? Some learners have calculated VAT on a net product, and some have got a figure, and we're going to try and go back over the calculations to see how they can come back off the VAT and so on and so on. And then what we'll do is we'll challenge the other group members to see how they can work that out.
So 24.99 times 5.
You divide the entire number by 10 and then times what you get by 2. That's 20%.
I'd divide by 5.
Yeah.
Make it a lot easier instead of doing it by one way in times and then up in times.
It is important that they open up. They have to ask questions and be able to also feel that they can challenge what I'm saying. And I often lure them. I often say, well, that's not, and then they will argue back, because I want them to be confident in their answer.
In front of you, you've all got three plastic tubes, correct? If we remember, when we're trying to calculate the volume of a cylinder,
they leave school thinking they don't need to do maths anymore. They have to know that the maths that they're doing is part and parcel of what they're required to do to trade. And it is only when we bring the physical, when we put water in this stuff, that they begin to see where they've gone right or gone wrong. We have an amazing amount of people across college, and not only in our own faculty, that are there to help us with maths. I really think the maths is an issue for us as well at our age. You know, we understand day-to-day maths. I call it street maths versus school maths. You know, currently, we need to teach them school maths. I want to teach them street maths. I want to get them to understand that it's about estimation. But of course there is, to get it correct, the formulas have to be there. Is that about right?
All right.
So that works. Guesstimation. I also know that your pencil rubber on the end of your pencils, your HB2s, you know, you've got a bit of metal on the rubber? 22 millimetre. What size pipe do we use?
22.
I don't need a ruler, I just know that's my inch.
Certainly we had the benefit of attending some training last year to help us understand a bit more about maths. And that has opened up a lot more cross-college conversations. The functional skills and the GCSEs that have changed this year has meant that I've worked a lot closely with some gentlemen within the faculty. Certainly from sharing good practice and different ideas. I think we're very fortunate here at Exeter that we have the ability to be able to talk to anybody across college. It's one college, not one faculty, 12 other faculties. It's one college. That's my own opinion for sure.